In this next video, we'll discuss buffer solutions, which have many practical applications, particularly in biological applications. And what we can say is that the pH value in buffered solutions change only very slightly upon the addition of small amounts of either acid or base. And a buffer has two functions. Number one, neutralize added acid, or two, neutralize added base. And when these neutralizations occur, is that these two components must not neutralize each other. So we can't just combine a solution that has an acid and a base, because they're going to neutralize each other. And in terms of designing a buffer, that's going to eliminate strong acids and strong bases for consideration, because they will neutralize each other. So let's look at some common buffer solutions. And there's three types of solutions that are going to meet the criteria that we need right here. Number one is a weak acid, and its conjugate base. And that conjugate base is going to be a salt solution. Number two is a weak base and its conjugate acid, also a salt. And the third common buffer solution is a strong acid and an excess amount of the conjugate base of a weak acid. So these are the type of buffer solutions we're going to analyze, and now that we've defined them, in the next video we'll go through and look at how particular buffers work and how they'll be able to neutralize any added acid or added base that come in contact with that particular solution.